Jan, thank you very much for your time, first of all. When was the last time you thought, why am I a goalkeeper?
I don't know. Normally, I don't ask myself that kind of questions because really I want to be a goalkeeper since I was a kid, since I remember for myself. So I'm always happy. Sometimes, of course, when you're in the goal, sometimes you cannot influence a lot in the game, but anyway, you are there, you try to help, you're doing your best, and you are there to defend, not to score the goals. And I'm really happy to do this, to be a goalkeeper. I don't see this like my job, I see this like my life. So I was never asking myself why I'm goalkeeper.
I was an amateur goalkeeper, and after the 10th time I had to go down and hurt my shoulder, I thought, why am I goalkeeper? So you also like going down training? You must do it like 60, 70 times in every training session going down.
Yeah, of course. I do all kind of training sessions. We are going down a lot of times, but I think my bones, my muscles, my body is used to that. So I really don't care if I go down one time or 60 times. I think I feel the same in the end of the training.
And of course, there is a strong reason why you are a goalkeeper. And in your case, it's not to do that. There are many goalkeepers that like the fact that they are different. They wear gloves, the shirt is different, the look is different. Did that have any influence at all for you or not?
No, but I think, okay, sometimes when you're a kid, it's like everyone wanna be a little bit different. So I think goalkeeper is that guy on the pitch, with gloves, with different shirt, maybe with long sleeves. So I don't know, I think it's nice even for the kids, but that's not the main reason I became a goalkeeper, just to be different. The main reason is for sure because my father was a goalkeeper, and me growing up, I was watching him, and for sure because of this, I decided to be a goalkeeper. I want to be like him.
But you accept that a little bit has to do with the different look, no? So I give you the chance to go to Jan Oblak, 7-year-old Jan Oblak, and you can say to him, don't be a goalkeeper, or be a goalkeeper. You can change his path in life. What would you say to him?
I think it's impossible to change it. It was something inside of me, and I don't know, even if somebody want me to be, I don't know, defender, midfielder, striker, I would not leave it. Doesn't matter if I was just 7 years old. I think it was impossible. I think I born with this to be a goalkeeper. I don't know. I don't know how to explain to. I don't know how to explain, but I'm sure it's something inside of you that you cannot change.
Should we try to explain it? Because obviously, your father had a massive influence, as you say. Did you admire him? Is that the first feeling, the strongest feeling you had for him when you were a kid?
Yes, of course. This is the strongest feeling. He was my first idol. I was watching him, like I said many times, I was behind the goal, and when he dived to one side, I dived to this side. When he dived to another side, I dived to another side. I dived to another side. So I was trying to do the things like he was doing. But he was not like that kind of father that he said, "Oh, you need to be a goalkeeper. You need to train." He always said, "Be what you want to be. Do what you want to do." So I was. I don't know, my wish, and probably, like I said, I admire my father, I still admire him, and when I saw him playing, I want to be like him.
Because I imagine as a kid, actually my dad was an amateur footballer, and the fact that he walked into a pitch watched by so many people, it was only 200, but anyway, there was a lot of people watching him, and that he had to act in front of those people was something to admire. Did you see him also like your dad was one person before he went to the pitch, and then a much bigger person somebody bigger to admire when he was on the pitch.
Yeah, of course. First of all, I want to say my father was an amateur goalkeeper as well. He was not professional. He was amateur, but anyway, he was a goalkeeper in my city when I was born. And of course, anyway, if there is just 100, 200, 300 people in the game, he need to act well. He need to do something that the people are going to be happy. So that is what I always admire in a football player, not just in my father, because in the end, somebody said that this is our job, but this is not our job. This is our, in the end, this is our life. We do this because we like it. You don't start train and play football thinking that this is going to be your job. You are just doing because you love it. And in the end, you are doing your best because you want to improve and you want to be better and better. So. My father was doing the same. He was an amateur goalkeeper all his life, but he trained and he played with all the passion.
That's very, very interesting, isn't it? Because a lot of people think amateur is just something on the side, but actually for amateur footballers, football is everything. It's just that they haven't made it their profession. You saw that as well in your father and the players that played with your father too.
Yes, of course. They were training, I think, at least 3-4 times per week as well. They was playing every weekend, so that football was part of their life. They had their jobs, but in the afternoon, when it was time for training, they trained. They do all kind of things like professional football player is doing. The difference is just that professional football player can think just about football. And amateur need to think how to earn money to live, to take care of the family, and then football, to play football because he loves football. So I think you need to admire every amateur player, not just like professional. Professionals, we are always thinking about professional, but I think the amateur player is like the player who really showed the passion for the game.
Jan, sorry to bring myself again into the question, but I'm the chairman of a football club in England in the ninth division. It's an amateur club. And I find that in those clubs, you find the essence of the game, where, you, as you say, you don't do it because of the money, you don't do it because of the glory, you don't do it because of the cameras, you do it because you're passionate about football. And the possibility of actually being close to all that is something that many kids love to do. So I guess, did you go to training? Did you go to the games? Did you love to be part of that world?
All days, you know, I was like, I went to every game when I can, when they take it me with them. So I really enjoy every moment of my childhood, because every moment of my childhood was about sport, about football. So I really have a great memories about that, about I for sure I learned a lot of things from amateur players, because in the end I saw what is passion, I saw what is that they are not doing this because of something, like you said, because of glory, because of camera, because of the people. They are doing that because they really like it.
And it sounds like you carried with you that amateur feeling to professionalism. But one thing that is very true, I'm very comfortable being the chairman of a football club that's amateur, because there is not so much pressure, really, because when it gets to elite football, it's a completely different world. At what point did football went away a little bit from that amateur feeling for you and became really a profession?
I started to play professional football with 16 years old, so I was a teenager. But anyway, when you start to train with the first team, when you start to play with the first team, you grow fast in the end. You are not anymore a teenager. You are an adult man on the pitch. Maybe in the private life, somebody sees you like a teenager, but you, even in the private life, you act different than your colleagues. Because you need to think different, you need to be prepared for that, you need to have a cold mind at this age, at 16 years old. So for sure it's not easy for everyone, but it's something that you like to do. It's something about what you're dreaming since you was a small kid. I think it's nothing more beautiful than that. I don't know, like I always say that in the professional football, they speak a lot about the pressure and these kind of things, but that it's something that we, I don't know, I don't feel it like a pressure. It's something like, it's like a joy. I can be happy that I can be on this stage. I can play football, a big games, that I can play against big players. So that's not a pressure. It's something inside of you that, I don't know, giving you, pushing you more to do more, to do more, to be better.
At 16, he was when you made your debut with the first team, and the story is great. Explain it yourself. You had Robert Bald as a goalkeeper coach and goalkeeper as well, and this is a veteran. Was he much older than you? And he's the guy who actually tells you go ahead of me. No, is that more or less the story?
Yeah, it was more or less like that. I remember that. It was 2008-2009. He was my coach and he was the first goalkeeper, and then I think the club was in the second league at this time, and I got the opportunity to play. I did it well, and then the season finished, we entered to the first league, we go to the first division, and I started playing there. So it was, of course, he was older than me. I think he was around 40, I was 16. So not just he, many players in the team, they had like double age of me. So it was like that I'm playing with my parents, or I don't know. But like I said, you don't feel young in the end. When you are with them, when you are there, you feel like them. You don't feel 16 years old.
And I guess you all have this poker face when you go onto the pitch, even as a 16-year-old, you find you control of everything. But do you remember your debut? I mean, what was in your head? Were you nervous? How was that like?
I remember it. It was amazing. I really don't know if I was nervous. I was so happy. Like I said, I was waiting for that moment since I born. So I was so happy that I think because of the happiness, I don't even think that I was nervous or not. I just go to the game. I did it good, so that was the most important. That was the only thing I was thinking about. But anyway, even if maybe your first game is not so good, even if you did some mistakes, you need to stay strong. You need to think that you're gonna improve and that you're gonna be better in the next game.
So once you become a professional, another kind of challenges appear to you. And I don't know if your relationship with your dad, for instance, changes at all, and dad becomes the one who comes to see you now and the one who advises you. Or what happens then with that relationship?
Oh, relationship was always the same, because like I said, he never advised me too much. He always leave me to that I do my things, that I decide for me, that I do what I think that is good. If I ask him, he respond me, but he was never that kind of guy who came and he said, no, you should do this, you should do like that. If I asked him, he respond, but he never, our relationship didn't change nothing. When I went from Slovenia, when I started professional football, it was always the same.
When you were growing up, were there goalkeepers that you looked at and admired or wanted to copy or learn from?
There was always goalkeepers, you know. Normally when you are young, you always watch maybe... Before was different. Before there was no internet, it was television, and you saw in the television when the game was in the television, and then depend which game was on the television. So, and then you... During the years, you admire different goalkeepers because maybe there were more matches on the television of, I don't know, England League, Premier League, Spanish League, Italian League. So, of course, I admire all of them. Like I said, I remember I admired one, in the beginning, Peter Schmeichel, then Van der Sar, Buffon, Casillas. It was like there is a lot of goalkeepers. I was watching them, but like I said, it was all depends which game is on the television.
There is something to admire about those names that you mentioned, because the goalkeeper job changed dramatically in the period from when they started to when they finished their career. Changed completely. For you, it hasn't changed so much, has it? You already had to be proactive. You already had to develop the way you play with the ball, with the feet, a series of things that they had to add to the game, no?
That's true. And that, I think, we need to admire, like you said, because in the end, when they start to play, the football was a little bit different, and when they finish, it was different. So during their career, they need to probably change the things, add the things to the game. And for sure, all their jobs help us right now to be at some level that we can do maybe some things that they didn't do 20 or 30 years ago. So, but that's like a process, and we need to admire them that they did this during their careers.
I'm fascinated about the art of goalkeeping and what process goes into your head in one of those saves that you don't remember, but I remember because I watch them all the time, and some of them are extraordinary. Your quick reaction, your movement, your anticipation, all that. So take us to one of them. Whatever. Imagine, I don't know, Salah is coming to you as, I think you made 9 extraordinary saves in Anfield. And he's coming to you. What is you thinking? So you imagine what come next, or do you have to be aware of the surroundings? What's the order of play in your mind before you take the decision that you take?
Normally you don't think what will happen next, for sure. First you check all around, you see him, and you prepare, you watch the ball, you watch his position of the body. But the great players, they can do one position of the body and they do totally different with the ball. So the most important is to keep focus on the ball, wait until the end, and when he shoot, when he try to dribble you, when he tried to pass to another player, then it's direction. There is direction. I think is the most important for a goalkeeper is the position, because if you are in good position, many times you don't need to do extraordinary reaction. So I think the most important is this, and to have your mind cold, wait till the end, and then stop the ball.
So actually, one of those extraordinary saves, maybe 1 or 2 or 3 or 10, had to do with the fact that you didn't do well the job before. Could that be right?
Many times it can happen like that. Many times when people see somebody who do an amazing save, in the end you need to do an amazing save because you're not in the right position. Sometimes it's not like that. Sometimes it's impossible that you're in the right position, but many times you have a different type of goalkeepers. You have a goalkeepers with a better position. You have a goalkeepers with better jump, with better dive. That's the difference, because sometimes maybe some balls you catch, it looks so easy, but in the end it's easy because of your position. And then many times some saves you do are amazing to see, but you know that your position was not good, and that because of this, you need to do this dive, and because of this, maybe it's more beautiful, but it's not more safe for the team. That's for sure.
I've spoke to Cañizares and Casillas about the huge amount of time that you've got on your own, but nobody's talking to you. And Casillas used to think about, I need to go shopping tomorrow, and there is a trip that I want to do. Well, Cañizares, to make sure that he was focused, he spoke to people behind him. And he liked the fact that some actually will not so much insult him, but put him under pressure, because that kept him kind of awake. What are you like with the huge amount of time that in which you're not involved in the game at all?
No, what I try and what I always do is like to speak with the players in front of me, not they don't speak with me, but I speak to them. correction them, go right, go left, go back, go in front, be careful there, be there. And when you are speaking, it's impossible that you are not concentrated. Doesn't matter if you don't do nothing all of the game, if you just have one ball in the end of the game, if you are concentrated, if you are speak, nothing leave you out from the game. So I think that's important. And now maybe when there are no people in the stadium, hopefully soon they're gonna be back. Probably even in the television and everywhere, people are hearing more of this conversation on the field, because when the stadium is full, when the atmosphere is amazing, it's impossible that somebody will hear what actually is happening on the pitch.
One of the changes of goalkeepers in recent times is that you have become a very important part of the offensive move. You decide what move the team is going to take, if it's going to be short, if it's going to be long. And that, of course, has to do with the tactics of the team. But it's your decision to actually do that. That makes you feel more important, doesn't it? That perhaps 10 years ago, where all your job was mostly defending, saving goals.
Yeah, I think for sure. And I think in the last years, every teams and all the people see how important the goalkeeper is, because in the end, it's not just somebody who is there to stop the ball. It's depend of the team, depend of the tactic. Like you said, the goalkeeper need to build the attack, play with the feet. And I think that's something that all of us are happy, because we like to participate more on the game. And it's something good for us, and it's something that are, I think, taking football to another level.
You're very young for a goalkeeper. I mean, you've got about 15 years to go, well, maybe 12, 10, I don't know how many, but certainly a whole decade at least in front of you, no?
Oh, hopefully. Like I said, I think that it depends a lot as well on the injuries and everything. I'm playing 12 years professional football, so I hope I'm going to play 10, 12 years more. But you never know. I'm going to do my best. I'm going to do everything to play as long as it will be possible.
Yeah, and you say that if you go to another league, you can play. You're the best goalkeeper in the world. Yes, you can play in the Premier League or in any other league. I'm convinced about that. You are very good. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.